Tennessee after the break. And we welcome you back now alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, getting set for quarter number three here. And how about this right out of the locker room? An onside kick attempt. The Falcons back to receive. They've got the lead, and they'll get this football as the second half gets underway. A very interesting call, and one that backfires. I know they're losing, Charles, but boy, to start the second half with the onside kick, risky.
Felt like a sense of urgency from their side, coupled with, you and I both know the special teams coordinators. They sell their key plays each and every week to the head coach, don't they? And I guarantee he's been selling this one. We can get it, coach, we can get it. And that came together with that sense of urgency you talked about.
Following the pickup of four, here's second and six. Here's Ryan. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down. If they want a first, they need to get the football to the 32 here on third down. Now a handoff here to his running back. And they'll get him down about 3 yards short of the first. Call it a gain of three, and it'll bring up fourth down.
Well, this was just simply excellent defense. On this third down, they had to be alert for the possibility of a pass, but that didn't stop them at all from understanding what was going on when they decided to run the football, and they just swarmed and stopped them for almost no gain.
They'll try and throw for it with Ryan. He completes this to Russell Gage. And he is out of bounds inside the 30.
I remember in pregame when we were talking to him on the field and he took his gloves off and showed us his fingers. A few misshapen ones in there. And now we know why, trying to catch those types of bullets.
That was a dart. Yeah, even for a talented receiver, those are tough to hang on to.
That looked like a pretty good route combination there, because you've got to find a way to clear the guy running the drag, because when you do, you just put the ball on him and then let him run.
He's got some space. Here's Ryan to throw. And this is caught for a Falcon touchdown. Tajay Sharpe, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Falcons push further out in front.
And that's a drive that makes everyone happy on that bench, because they accomplish exactly what they set out to do. Take care of the football, eat up a little clock, end up in the end zone. Now they've got a cushion for the rest of the game. So they didn't just help themselves offensively, they helped their defense out as well.
Extra point by Koo, up and good. And it's now 21-7. Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. Reed going to bring it out of the end zone. And they'll be backed up to start this drive as he's taken down right around the 15.
In this position, trying to get back into the game, teams are looking for a spark from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover if they want to try and put points on the board.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. Oh, this one incomplete. The pressure got to him as he released it. And it's second down.
I'm getting the sense that this offense is getting frustrated. Here we are into the third quarter, and they've had plenty of opportunities to get in sync. Thus far, that hasn't happened. They're looking for answers both on the sideline and in the huddle looking at each other.
Steps away. And Metcalf, what a catch. And he'll be out of bounds right at the 40.
That is one heck of a catch right there. Got his eye on it the whole way and able to make the grab one-handed. Very nicely done, and for a nice chunk of yardage, too.
They'll roll him out right. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
I'm sure this isn't a novel thought, but maybe run some simpler routes instead of trying to get it all back in one shot. Defense certainly appears to be ready for him. Try and get it back little by little instead of in big chunks.
To throw on second and 10. Wilson rolling to his left. This one into the hands of Metcalf. And he will go out right near the 35-yard line.
because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
Throwing now, Wilson on first down. He'll buy some time right, finding room to the 20, and he's going to get it down to the 14-yard line. There's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. This is intercepted. Picked off by A.J. Terrell. And a terrific return as he takes this thing all the way down near the 20-yard line. I tell you what, credit is due there on them preventing the touchdown after that interception.
How about him chasing him down and not giving up the pick six? Because what happens a lot of the time is when you see the interception, you just kind of hang your head a little bit and you momentarily pause because you're frustrated. He shook that off and gave great chase and got it done.
Still a great return and very good field position. They'll throw on first down with Ryan. And this is caught at the 8. And he will reach the 8-yard line before going out. This offense continues to be a hot knife through butter. 3 drives, 3 scores, and knocking on the door again on drive number 4. Give right side. It's Patterson, and they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 9. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Another shot from the 9 on second and goal. Now it's Ryan, and that will be taken in by Ridley for a Falcon touchdown. A 9-yard touchdown there, and the Falcons use the short field to their advantage as they cash in for 6. So an important touchdown right there is now they're really beginning to pull away.
Yeah, this was a tight game until not too long ago. But since then, they've hit the accelerator, and they pushed the lead up to 3 scores here in the fourth quarter, and I don't see them looking back.
Ku able to connect on the extra point, and the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. Following the touchdown, here's Ku to kick off. Here's Reed. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21. Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. And they had a nice little drive going last time through the interception in the red zone. Costly.
Bad enough to throw it anywhere, but that drives coaches insane when they're thinking about, hey, we got a shot at points already. We're already in a spot where you're thinking you've got 3 on the board for sure, and to come away with nothing, that's a really tough one for them to swallow.
Yeah, will they make up for it? Again on 2nd and 10, it's Wilson. He's got a man complete. 20, 10, and all the way in, touchdown Seattle. Tyler Lockett, 78 yards. And the Seahawks have got it back to a 2-score game here in the 4th. Extra point up and through by Myers. And the lead will be cut down to 14. And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. Returnable here for Davis. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. set to begin their next drive. The Falcons offense at the line. Now there are two scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs. To keep up with your theme there, playing keep away, first downs, they can't touch the ball.
The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. Once more, they turn to Patterson. And this carry not as productive. He swallowed up at the line of scrimmage. The Falcons on third down. Just one for three thus far. This is third and seven. And that is incomplete. Critical play in this football game, because if they pick up the first there, that clock keeps rolling.
Has to be a little frustrating for them, because they know that they pick up a first down there and continue to eat away at the clock. Really increases their chances of closing this one out. Now they're likely going to have to give the football up and sweat it out on the sideline.
Fourth down. Here's Ryan. And intercepted. Maybe the turning point they need. Picked up by DJ Reed. And the return here is stopped at the 35-yard line. Now with that interception, you feel like we got a ball game again. Remember, two-score contest and still time left here in the fourth.
And in the old days, not too long gone either. Throwing the ball here would have been an absolute no-no, but the way the game's played now, throwing it makes sense. You just have to be careful when you put it in the air.
After the interception, here's Wilson. Buying time to his left. Going for Metcalf on the deep ball. Touchdown, Seahawks! DK Metcalf, 35 yards. And the Seahawks have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. Myers connects on the PAT. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. Returnable here for Davis. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. After the touchdown we just saw, we have a brand new ball game. And now look at the situation. You've got plenty of time on the clock. Defensively, they have three timeouts. So do you run the football here or do you throw it?
I think you have that full conversation with your offensive unit. And you tell them, here's the situation. They've got all of their timeouts, so we are not going to play this conservatively. We've got to attack them. We've got to make them use those, gain the ground that we need in order to put this game away. If you think we're just going to run it three times and punt it, you've got another thing coming.
Yeah, and by the way, also the two-minute warning in play, so essentially four timeouts left.
They have to be aggressive here. And these guys certainly are not hiding what their intention is. They're absolutely showing it. They're definitely not going to sit on this lead here in the fourth quarter.
They'll run on first down. Patterson, and he can only manage to get a couple. Second and eight coming up. Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. From the 44, Ryan. That's caught at the 25. Touchdown, Falcons. Matt Ryan connecting on his fourth touchdown pass of the ball game. And the Falcons use the big play to extend their fourth quarter lead. That's a pretty quick response to that last touchdown drive, and it seemed like they had maybe given up momentum. Not so fast.
No, not at all, because they end up pushing the lead up once again, and you're exactly right. Thought momentum might have been shifting. Instead, they grabbed old Mo, didn't let him get to the opposite sideline.
Extra point by Koo, up and good. And the lead now up to 14. Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. Here's Reed returning. And he'll go down as this drive will start at the 25-yard line. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
It takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense and exploit.
Blitz coming, and down he goes. A hole to dig out of here, second and 17. Another try after the first down sack. Wilson steps away to his left. He's going to let it fly. Down under 2 minutes to go in this football game. And that went a little too high as it's knocked away and incomplete. So it's Seahawk football as we march toward a conclusion. They face a third down now as they try to find a late score. They take a shot downfield there, but it winds up falling incomplete.
That means it's just one last chance left, and this has to be a first down or a touchdown, or this game's over.
They're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. Here we go. It's Wilson on fourth down, being chased out left. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Wilson. He hits his target, Lockett. And he's going to be out down inside the 20 at the 15. Clock management definitely critical here if they want to get back in this game.
Absolutely agreed. They have to up the tempo in this case, down a couple of scores. Want to make sure they have a chance to win this ball game.
From the red zone now, here's Wilson on first down. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Whew, that's certainly not the worst thing. It stops the clock and lets your offense catch its breath and lets us exhale a little bit. Now I expect them to call a couple plays in the huddle so they're ready if a tackle happens inbounds.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Now Wilson. And that one going to be off target and incomplete.
After what they faced during this game where they've given up a ton of yards downfield, that has to be a measure of revenge right there for the secondary. They've been shredded throughout the game and finally forced an incompletion.
This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10. Throwing is Wilson. And this is caught out for a late touchdown. So hold everything here. This one's not over yet. Okay, game on. Don't go anywhere yet. You got a one-score game now. Probably going to rely on the onside kick coming up.
Yeah, they have to. It's not a high-percentage play, but it's better than not having a chance at all. And that's when you put your leapers and your flyers on one side, get that high hop, and hope that one of the guys can come up with it.
And on the other side, get that hands team ready.
No doubt about it.
The touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. Returnable here for Davis. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And checking the timeouts, they do have two defensively, but no real need to use them as they're not going to be able to stop the clock after that. They're going to start the drive here on the ground with Patterson. And able to stay on his feet past the 30 to about the 33-yard line. Now the Seahawks call the second of their three timeouts as they get it with under a minute to go now in the football game. Now Ryan airing it out, looking for Ridley. And the defense loses him. It's complete. And he's across for the touchdown. And in the final minute, that should just about seal it.
And that touchdown should make you feel comfortable. But do you really feel like it's totally over yet?
Not totally, but I think you're pretty much there.
Yeah, you still got to make sure you stay with it, do all the right things down the stretch, especially on defense. But that touchdown there, you've got to feel good about your chances.
Ku able to connect on the extra point, and the lead now up to 14. Following the touchdown, here's Ku to kick off. Here's Reed. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory.
Well, he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And he takes this one into the end zone, and all of a sudden, here in the final minute, things get a little bit tighter.
And there's the touchdown that they needed, so they'll celebrate. But the guys on the sidelines, they've got to stay focused. The onside kick team, they need them to get the ball back.
Yeah, part one of the equation done. Now they need to convert and get that onside kick. Extra point up and through by Myers. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. Returnable here for Davis. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And this one all over but the shouting, you might say. Now, there's one timeout remaining defensively, but probably no real need to use it here.
Yeah, the only time they would use it, strictly for pride.
Now the Seahawks forced to use their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with 27 seconds showing on the clock.